pain right now.
Yeah, well, it just made it easier for you to carpool.
Anyway, I...
Where are we going?
You know what they use to mine all around these parts?
Yeah, mercury or something.
That's right, cinnabar. They extracted mercury from cinnabar. Folks back east think it was gold mines out here and silver. Not so. Back in the early 1900s, cinnabar was worth more than gold. To operate the mine, you need TNT for expansion, blowing out new tunnels, clearing cave-ins, that sort of shit. And to own TNT, you had to register with the county. Keep copies of the keys to all your lockboxes with the commissioner.
Wait, the county courthouse? Where the hell is that?
Thought you knew. It's in the old federal building.
The old federal building? The one in Sherman's camp? Jesus, Mike, what the hell? You told me... You told me that you were never setting foot in that place again.
Did I? I don't recall.
You were drunk right after... Joe was killed.
Did I tell you why?
No.
Here. Turn right here. This is it.
Mike, the place is gonna be crawling. I don't think this is a good idea.
Weather holds, we'll be safe enough. All right. That there? It's the old federal building. That's where we're headed.
Let's not go looking for trouble. Stay out of the buildings. Come on. We gotta head over this way.
Where are we headed?
Just follow me. Key'll be on the commissioner.
And you know where he is? Where his body is?
Yeah, I think I do.
You heard what happened here?
Yeah. Everybody got wiped out, man, woman, and child. Only a few got out, and you were one of them, right?
Only two got out. Me and Nora. But it wasn't the freaks that took us out.
What do you mean?
Here.
Has called a truce. A meeting. Right here. Oh, we knew what was coming. We knew what was coming and we were prepared. fight. It didn't last long. But it was bad. They had ammunition left after all, and... well, they... oh, hell, you can see what they did. Like I said, two people walked out of this town after all was said and done. And some days... I wish to hell one of them wasn't me. Commissioner's over there in the bean counter suit. Go get the key so we can get the hell out of here.
You didn't give a damn about sealing the caves. You brought me here you brought me here because you wanted me to see this.
Not true. All right, you got the key. We're gonna go get the maps to those mines, just like I said, and we're gonna get more than enough TNT to seal every cave in the valley.
Bullshit.
You are right about one thing. I'm not sorry you've seen it.
Not following you, Mike.
I am talking about the war that's coming. With the Rippers. The one that Schizo's so hot for. You think he cares how many die? On either side? Never mind. Come on, let's get this done.
I can use this. Here's the door.
Place is locked up tight. Come on. Gotta find a way upstairs.
Smells like something died in here.
Newts. Yeah, I smell them. Bad business. Never much like kids. They always tended to get on my nerves. It was always a sore spot between me and my Elizabeth. God rest her soul.
You didn't like kids. Wow, here I thought you liked everyone.
Almost no one, point of fact. But I tolerate most. Even smart-ass drifters. Come on.
Okay. All right, this is it. Now we got maps to every mine in the county showing where they stored their dynamite. Okay, come on. Yeah.
Were you expecting anyone?
Nope.
Do you have my back here?
Hey, I don't like starting trouble, but I'll finish it if I have to.
Stay behind me.
Hey, I could take care of myself.
I'm not saying you can't, but remember the last time that we were out in the shit.
Yeah, like I said, I'm staying behind you.
They're coming!
Oh, yeah. I'm right behind you.
Jesus, what a mess!
Now you know why no one goes into Sherman's camp.
Addie finds out you're out here risking your ass like this, she's gonna be pissed.
Now how would she find out about something like that?
Not from me. About the Rippers, why you wanted me to see that shit?
You know, Deke? I always saw a bit of myself in you, back in the day.
How's that?
Don't give a shit. Oh, you care about your friends. Don't want to see him die, but me? Any other goddamn person on the planet, I don't think so.
Caring will just get you killed.
Yeah, that's right. Thing is, not caring will get you killed just as easy. Good folks of Sherman Camp did was stop caring about anyone but themselves and their own. Easy to kill a man when he's just some piece of meat standing between you and what you need. Schizo wants to kill Rippers because he don't think they're human anymore. They don't count. Standing in the way of what he wants. Well, I don't buy into that shit. I won't have it.
You know, Schizo, he wonders why I'm a pacifist. That's what he likes to call me. He thinks I'm gonna get everybody killed.
Well, are you, Mike? Are you gonna get everyone killed?
Freaks aren't gonna be around forever. Now, when they're gone, we're gonna need some folks around here to help pick up the pieces. Hey, look, hey. I don't like Carlos and his Rippers any more than I like Tucker or Copeland and his goddamn truthers. All right, but here, look. Here's the thing, Deke. I'm not going out of my way to kill any of them. I've had my share of killing.
Even if Carlos comes for you?
My truce will hold. You can bet on that.
I agree with Schizo. The Rippers, they ain't human. Not anymore. I wonder how Booth is holding up. I guess I should go check on him. Hope he's awake.
Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Yep. See you around.
How's it going?
Just looking for some stuff.
All right, I got you. See you around.
How's it going, brother?
No, Deke. I don't know about you, but I could use a hand.
You lay down.
Yes, ma'am.
You can't have visitors just yet, but I could really use a hand.
Okay, I'll see you later.
I'll be here. Hey, Doc, seriously, though. Will I be able to play piano after all this is over?
Very funny, William. Lay down.
Okay. I could play chopsticks. No, seriously, I could. I'd be like...
As you can see, he's gonna be just fine. His fever's completely gone.
Good, that's good. All right, well, I gotta go take care
Deacon,
of some shit.
Like I said before, William really does owe you his life.
Boozer doesn't owe me shit. I owe him.
Hey. I saved two more. Eddie and Mia would have died without those antibiotics. I just thought you should know.
Seems like he's getting better.
You need something?
That's right, I gotta burn out the rest of these nests.
Deke, you gotta hurry.
Ricky, what's going on?
That guy we've been looking for, Eric Lynch, who murdered Campbell and Reed, at the...
Brian, I'm at one of your beacons, the one outside of Rogue Camp.
Drifter, St. John, I mean, copy that.
Why am I here?
I show, Hilo incoming to that location now. Be ready. O'Brien out.
That's why I'm here.
St. John, they should have arrived at your location. Do you see them?
Yeah, kind of hard to miss. What do you need me to do?
Get close to the researcher. Remember, you have to stay in their proximity or I can't intercept their data.
Okay, yeah, I get it.
I need the area secured now.
I gotta place a tracker on that chopper.
Sound off.
Come on, guys, just gotta clear out.
Clear!
Can't let them see me.
LZ's clear.
So what the hell are you boys doing here, huh? Stop and fill up at the old Peltro gas station. Guess you didn't see that sign says gas. Got it. Brian, the tracker's set. You should be getting to lunch.
Yep, done. No, 2060. We've now completed the survey of 24 nesting sites, including those at Marion Forks, Pioneer Cemetery, the Cascade Highway Lumber Site, the truck stop on the old Belknap Road.
Ah, Crazy Willies.
Yes, very rustic and touristy. Some things about the old world I don't miss. A Crazy Willies, south of the Belknap Crater.
I got a question, Doc.
Sure, it's not like I'm busy or anything.
The nests. Why do they build them?
We don't know.
Why do they only build them in, you know, building structures? Cabins, things like that?
We have a theory that...
We never see them where wild animals were built. Trees or out in the wilderness, only houses.
You finished?
Sorry.
The guys back at the lab have a theory. I'm sure when they're ready to talk about it, they'll come rushing down to the barracks to let you know.
Jesus. Just ask it. I see things too, you know. I wasn't always a grunt, you know.
Okay. Can I continue?
Sure.
South of Belknap Crater. Some areas of the Belknap Wilderness were not surveyed due to the proximity of nesting sites to human encampments. In particular, a large camp at...
Salome Hot Springs.
Oh, yes. Salome. On Herod's birthday, she danced before them, whereupon he promised with an oath to give her whatsoever she would ask. She said, "Give me the head of John the Baptist."
Anyone else hear that?
The king was struck sad. Quite the name for a resort.
Oh, shit.
Again, some things about the old world I don't miss.
Upload complete.
Yeah.
The fuck was that?
Bible? Now they're reciting Bible verses. That must be nice. Flying all over hell and gone and finding time to read. Jesus, O'Brien. Done. Okay, now I just gotta get the hell out of here before one of them spots me.
Brian, are you there?
I can't talk right now. I'll be on this channel later. Out.
Brian.
God damn it.
Getting tired of being your errand boy, O'Brien. I'll come back later. Finish burning out these nests.
How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
All right, I got you. Sure, all right. Let me know if you need anything.
Hey, how's it going? What can I do you for? Okay, all right. See you later.
Wait a sec, I got it.
Captain Corey! Hey, Captain Corey! Just radio him, damn it! The outpost is under attack! Corporal, gotta move out! Gotta move out! Corporal, there's more coming! Corporal!
Alive? Oh, come on. No. Why?
Before he ran, he stole two bags of seed. Deke, we need those seeds.
Ah, shit.
We need to know where he sold them or stashed them.
You're making my day a lot more complicated, but okay, fine. I'll chase him down. Deacon out. Shit, there he is!
searched out!
Mitch, man! No, you're not gonna get away.
How's it going, Lynch, man? What, is the camp not feeding you well enough?
Fuck you!
Thought you just killed a couple guys right off with our shit? Don't matter if a bunch of folks here die of starvation because you got what you need, right?
Get off of me, you son of a bitch!
Hey, listen to me. Rick is gonna send some men for you. You tell them where you stash the seeds. Maybe they'll just shoot you, you know, instead of hanging you slow. What do you think about that?
I don't know what the hell you're talking about!
Hey, man, suit yourself. Hey, Ricky, I got him, and I'll send you his position. Send someone out here to pick him up.
Does he have the seeds on his bike?
No, I didn't see him.
All right, we'll bring him in. Lost Lake out.
See you, Lynch, man.
How's it going?
Just looking around.
You go through a lot of this shit, yeah?
Okay.
All right.
Hey.
Hey, Blair.
Good one. Yep. Thanks for stopping by.
Hey, I got a job for you.
You got a job for me?
Yeah. There's a bunch of dead freaks. The west of the footbridge stuck in the muck. I need someone to pull them out and take them to the burn pile. Got it?
Marsh duty.
Yeah.
Get someone else. I'm busy.
Hey, I'm getting you to do it. I don't know what Mike told you on your little field trip, but we got work to do. Here.
Hey. Schizo, he can't come with you, he's coming with me.
Last I checked, I wasn't talking to you.
Well, I checked in with Mike. I gotta go into the shit, and he's coming with me. All right?
Like I said, I'm busy.
And when you get back, you come find me.
You coming?
Where?
Doesn't matter.
Seriously, where are we headed?
North.
Ricky, I don't have time for your crap any more than Schizo's.
Come on, I'll show you. Mike told me what you did.
I didn't do anything.
About how if we seal the caves here, we can stop the hordes.
Never said it would stop them. Maybe slow them down. Look, are you going somewhere with this?
Yeah. I just thought that maybe you decided to stay. I mean, not just because of Boozer, but because you wanted to help.
Is that what you thought?
Hey.
Back in the day, I did my share of runs.
You did, but never anything more than that, and you know it. So now you're helping Iron Mike seal the caves? What did you want me to think? A few weeks back, we lost a man when this went down, shutting down the infirmary's respirator.
Respirator? Oh, God. Ricky, look around. If you're on a respirator out here, you're already dead.
What if it'd been Boozer? Yeah, that's what I thought. See, we haven't had power for almost 2 years, but the transformers and the lines, they all check out. Well, at least they do here. I want to ride up north, check out the hydro dam, just to see why it shut down.
Oh no, riding escort, that's Schizo's job.
I don't need an escort. You lived up there, you know the area better than anyone. Deacon, you asked for my help, right? Now I'm asking for yours. Okay, good. I'm gonna go grab some of the guys
that
can rut.
No, you're not. Now we're going in quiet. We're running to Copeland's men. I can handle them, but that wilderness up there is crawling with rippers and scumbags and God knows what else. More men, you know what that means? That means more attention. No, no, we're doing this my way.
Shit. Fine. Okay, let's go.
Look, Ricky, I gotta ask you. The other night, in the infirmary.
Would I have shot you in the face? No.
Really? Oh. From the look on your face, you...
I would have taken you outside first and then shot you in the face.
Okay, so you wouldn't, you know, want to get blood all over the infirmary.
Uh-huh, exactly. If we get an early start, we can get back before dark.
As long as nothing goes wrong.
Well, what can go wrong? Following you?
Just follow the route that I marked on your map. There's some marauder camps up there we want to stay away from.
Yeah, got it.
So how did you end up out here? I never asked you.
Same as everyone, I guess. When shit went down, I was 100 miles from home. The time I got back, everyone was gone.
Where are you from?
Grew up in a little town outside of Portland. Would work in the city, couch surf, go home on weekends.
Big city.
Yeah, right. Only in Oregon.
What was it like over there? I mean, how did you get out?
I don't know. Luck, I guess. Roads were backed up all the way down the coast. One giant parking lot. Willamette Valley was a war zone. Everything happened so fast. I told my friends to get out when I left. I don't think they listened to me.
I heard they nuked it.
Portland? Yeah, I heard that too. Don't think it's true. We'd be feeling the fallout, right?
Yeah. So, you and Addy.
You got a problem?
Me? No. Come on. I didn't know. You rode with us a long time. I guess it never came up.
I was like you. Seemed like, I don't know, keeping your distance was just a good way to stay alive.
Okay, look, I shouldn't have asked. None of my business.
That's why I'm at the camp. You know, chance to live a normal life again.
Good luck with that.
It's nothing serious. Me and Addy?
Didn't look that way to me.
Yeah, well, things happen fast these days. You know what I mean?
Didn't ask. I wanted to tell you something.
Shoot.
Look, I appreciate you going to bat for me. For me and Boozer. With Iron Mike, I mean.
Wow, you are getting soft.
Fuck off.
You've never thanked me for anything.
Yeah, well, maybe I never had any reason to.
Okay. So where'd you and Iron Mike go the other day?
Wait, you said that he already told you about it.
He was pretty tight-lipped. I've known Iron Mike a long time. To be honest, I don't think I've ever seen him so, I don't know, depressed. Where'd you go?
Sherman's camp.
I heard that place was a freak show.
It is, but we didn't have much of a choice. I had an idea about sealing the caves, keep the hordes from coming through. He knew where the mining claims office was. We picked up some maps. He's gonna track down some explosives.
Your radio must be broken. Almost sounded like you volunteered for some shit.
I'm riding with you now, aren't I? Jesus.
You just wanted out of Marsh duty.
Okay, you got me.
So what happened? Something happened.
Nothing, Ricky. Nothing happened.
He didn't say anything?
Just no. No. Nothing happened. And no, Iron Mike didn't say anything. Like you said, he's a pretty tight-lipped guy. All right, dam's coming up. Take it slow near the gate. No idea who or what might be living there.
Got it.
Well, looks clear.
Are you expecting trouble?
Yeah, always. And if we run into any, we're gone.
All right, come on. I want to check the outflow.
Where are you going?
Down here. Oh, no, no, no. Hey, this isn't right. There should be more water flowing out right there.
Yeah?
Yeah, and you hear that?
What?
Exactly. If the turbines were running, you'd be able to hear the hum of the lines from here. Oh. What happened there?
What? Oh. Same thing that happened to all the bridges. Smart men in uniforms decided blowing them up would keep the hordes from coming in.
Hordes of refugees or hordes of freaks?
Oh, you figure men like Copeland? Probably both.
All right, come on, I want to check something out. Come here, touch this. Come on. Okay. You feel anything?
No.
Exactly. If more water was flowing, the turbines would be vibrating. Come on.
Up this way. We're going all the way up to the top, up there.
Following you.
See these pipes? They're called the penstock. Water pressure builds up from the reservoir and is pushed down through those pipes, concentrating the force of the flow, which goes right through to the turbines.
How the hell do you know all this stuff?
I had two older brothers who were always fixing cars and shit with my dad. He got me a job at Boeing when I was only 17. I was going to school part-time to become a mechanical engineer when shit went down.
Did you ever see him again? Your dad, brothers?
No.
Let's figure this out. Well, this is gonna be fun.
So now wait. What's going on? What are you doing?
We only rode together a few months, but in all that time, I never saw you volunteer for anything. One of us has to jump down there and clear the intake. So, I'm up. Oh, but you can stand and watch. Okay. Oh, it's now or never. Let's go.
Yeah, it's pretty mucked up. I think I can clear it, though. Run back down to the turbine. See if it's vibrating at all.
Nothing. Wait a second. There it is. Yeah, that did it.
Ha ha! You feel that vibration?
Yeah, but the power lines are still dead.
What? Man, oh, it couldn't be that easy, right? All right, come on, let's check out the transformers.
So, your dad and your brothers, what happened to them?
I don't know. On my way back, I tried calling over and over. I always got a busy signal. By the time I reached the house, it was deserted. The entire neighborhood was deserted. There were flyers everywhere, evacuation orders. I went to the closest refugee camp, but it was overrun. Everyone was dead. Freaks were everywhere.
Jesus, Ricky, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
But these are the ones feeding the lines going south.
Any idea what's wrong with them?
No, not a clue. Okay. Well, it might be a short in the turbine junction boxes, so let's just go down and check it out. Okay?
All right. So, what's with you and Schizo? I mean, it seems like you're always on the verge of ripping his throat out.
A few months back, Eddie and I caught him hiding outside our cabin while we were bathing.
What? God, he's a peeping Tom.
I told him if it happened again, he'd find out that my gun is bigger than his.
Jesus. You know, if Addie was there, Schizo probably wasn't looking at you.
It was all I could do to stop her from neutering the bastard.
Ouch.
Right? Never piss off a woman who knows how to use a scalpel. Here, boost me up.
Okay, got it.
There. Here, I got the gate. Come on, junction room's right around here.
Oh, God, what is that smell?
Freaker nests. From the smell of it, more than a couple. Stay close. How many Molotovs you got with you?
Enough.
Okay. Remember the drill. You light them up, I knock them down.
It's been...
Here they come!
Ready.
Yeah, I can always use this. Time to burn. Here they come! Good?
Yeah. They really don't like visitors much, do they?
Well, can you blame them?
Whew. Well, they better get used to this shit. You know what? As of today, I'm claiming this for Lost Lake Camp.
The heart of the people.
All right, let's check the junction boxes and get the hell out of here. This is it. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. Damn. Yes! Houston, we have power.
Nice work.
I couldn't have done it without you.
Come on, let's find something to block the door in. I don't want to have to come back up here every month to clean this shit out.
Wait, you're gonna be here in a month?
What? No, I don't know. Would you just... Jesus.
I'm just fucking with you, Deke. Come on.
So, why'd you ask about my dad and my brothers?
I don't know. He just, you never mentioned him before, so, you know, I'm sorry if I...
if it's something you didn't want to talk about.
Oh, that's fine. In fact, it reminded me of something I wanted to ask you back when we were riding together.
Okay, Ricky. Ricky, not now. You can ask me later.
Let's go. Hey. Hey.
Come on. We gotta get moving.
Hey, you never asked why I stopped riding with you and Boozer.
Was I supposed to ask? I already knew why. Iron Mike's bullshit. God, Ricky, do we gotta do this now?
We had been riding together for, I don't remember, a couple months. Deep on.
Okay.
Okay. There was this one night, and I remember it really clearly. It was snowing outside, and Boozer was snoring. Remember how he used to snore? I swear, I thought he was going to bring a horde down on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, pretty much hasn't changed.
Anyway, he thought everyone was asleep, and you were sitting outside by yourself, like you always did, and you were staring at something. You didn't sleep the whole night. Let me see the photo, Deke. Come on, please. This is when I knew.
What'd you know, Ricky?
That I didn't want to end up like so many of us here. We're trapped in the past or running from it. I want to look forward. Okay? Not back.
This isn't what you think it is, okay?
Get low! You're on the back! Find them!
Are you sure it's them?
I saw the mark on his back!
We're from Lost Lake Camp. Iron Mike has a treaty!
Well, that was a really good idea. You wanna try that again?
Yes.
Stay put. Keep your head down.
Shit.
Well, you assholes are kind of far from home, aren't you?
God damn it.
What are you doing? Drag your asses back to Iron View. Find the shit where you crawled out from! North, aren't you? Huh? You don't want to get too far away from Carlos, do you? Make all the freaks out here happy, yeah? Huh? Isn't that what you want? I think that's the last of them.
I've seen rippers before, but not like that. What the hell are they amped up on?
No idea.
Back in the day, dealt with a few tweakers who acted like that. I think they're on PCP or whatever that other shit is.
Oh, bath salts. Remember? That was becoming a thing before everything went down.
Right, yeah. Come on, let's see if they messed up our bikes.
Really think that Iron Mike's treaty with these bastards is gonna hold?
I don't know.
Fucking rippers after what they did to Boozer's arm, after what they did to Lisa, what?
This was clutched in one of their hands. What happened? Did you guys have a run-in, you and Boozer, with the Rippers before you stole the antibiotics?
Well, I don't know. Look, whatever Carlos thinks I did, ain't gonna compare to what I'm gonna do to him if I ever see the son of a bitch.
Come on, let's go.
Stop you?
How'd you end up in the MC?
It's a long story.
We got a long ride.
Okay, I was a member of the 10th Mountain, part of a forward unit working with the Northern Alliance.
Shit, I didn't know you were in the Army. Why were...
You want to hear this or not?
Sorry.
We were advancing on Mazar-e Sharif. We got ambushed by a group of Taliban heading the other way. And they were in flatbed trucks, decked out with ZU-23s, modified anti-aircraft guns.
Big guns?
Yeah, really big fucking guns. Our Humvee exploded, went over a cliff, right into the Hari. You know how hard it is to drown in Afghanistan? It's hard. The place is one giant goddamn desert. Anyway, I was thrown clear, and when I came to, the Humvee was upside down in the river. I swam out to see if anyone survived. I pulled a body back to shore, and I did that 7 more times. And by the time I pulled in Tanner, my Sarge, I was done. When I came home, I don't know, I bought a bike, spent a couple of years on the road, just moving from place to place, and,
To farewell? You come around here, right?
Yeah. Okay, so... By the time I finally settled down, I got a job at a bike shop run by this old guy named Jack. And he ran the club. The press, that's what we used to call him. He patched me in himself.
Wait, Jack, I remember Boozer talking about it. He was in prison or something.
Some bad shit went down and he ended up taking the rap for the club.
Sounds like you guys were pretty tight.
Had to be one, right?
Let's come back in the morning. You can get whatever tools you need and we'll finish it up then. There'll be fewer freaks out.
So no hot shower tonight? Okay, but I want to show you something first.
Oh, Ricky, it's been a long day.
Come on, you know a lot about the freaks. I just want to show you something you might not know. Come on, we're out here anyway.
Shit, okay.
Let's go.
Can I ask you something?
God, like I said before, could I stop you?
Why are you still flying colors?
I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Boozer, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
No.
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once, and they said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, cops, authority, the government. What are you rebelling against?
Whatever's left. Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just... Cut? That's who I am. I've done a lot of stupid shit in my life, but joining the MC, well... Let's just say that it's...
Ricky, what are we doing here? I've seen the Nero death trains before and hordes.
I know. Not like this.
What the fuck?
Watch. I've come out here a few times to see them. They stay in those old machine buildings and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what, hibernate?
You mean you never went down there to see?
Aha. Uh-huh. No. One time I got way too close, and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Okay. Okay, anyway, the other day, I saw something you won't believe.
Really? You want to talk? All right, let's hear it. Wait, let me guess. You saw a Nero helicopter.
Wait, how did you know about that?
They've been spotted a few times, all over Lost Lake.
Shit.
Why do you care? It's not like they're here to help us. From the sound of it, they shoot on sight.
I don't care.
Oh, sounded like you did.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Nice to see you, too.
Yeah, well, Schizo said you and Deacon took off, and I was worried.
Addy, I'm tired, okay?
Oh, that's rich.
Hey, Dee, thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
It's bullshit.
What is your problem?
No, no! What is your problem?
I just said, I'm tired. That's it.
Okay. I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?